Hello friends, welcome again. Friends, in our previous videos, we discussed the differences between drama and novel. We know that novel is a pure form of literature, but drama, on the other hand, is not a pure form of literature. Why? Because the success of drama entirely depends upon stage conditions. So friends, today, in this video lecture, we want to understand how drama is dependent on different stage conditions available to the dramatist. Okay, friends, we know that there are some common characteristics, some common elements among drama and novel. In both drama and novel, you find plot construction, you find characters, you find settings, you find dialogues. These are common things commonly found both in drama and novel. But drama is different from novel. Why? Because the success of drama entirely depends on the stage conditions available to the dramatist. The success of the drama depends how the actors perform different roles of different characters in the drama. Okay, it is in fact drama, it is said that it is a three-dimensional work of art. Okay, why three dimensions? Why? Because number one, drama is first of all written by the dramatist in the form of books. Okay, then number two, drama depends, requires a stage to be performed. Okay, number two, and number three, drama needs some good actors to play the role of the characters. Okay, so that's why, you know, drama is considered three-dimensional, right? So the success of drama, as I told you, depends on these three different aspects. Okay, among these three, stage conditions play a very important role in the success of drama. Dr. S. Devika has rightly remarked, if you read these lines, you will understand how much weightage is given to stage conditions in drama. Dr. S. Devika rightly says that it is literature that walks. It is, means here we are talking about drama. Drama is a piece of literature that walks and talks before our eyes. Okay, it is an art that stresses on theatricality for its impact. Okay, so drama is an art which depends on theater, okay, and how theater influences different characters. The art of drama is closely bound up with stage conditions, okay, the skill of the actors, the taste of the audience before whom it is staged. All these things come together to make drama successful, or sometimes drama fails because of such conditions. Okay, so friends, now let's now start the discussion in detail. The novel, we know, is an independent form, but drama needs some elements like actors, some stage managers, sometimes costumes and properties and all. Okay, while the novelists create their background through descriptions, okay, the novelist narrates everything. The novelist creates the background, the situation, through words only, and this facility, this liberty is not given to the dramatist. The dramatist depends on stage properties for the creation of settings in his play. Okay, in drama, the required atmosphere or the whole mood on the stage is created by the skillful use of different costumes, right, makeup, lights, music and everything, right? So it all depends upon all these things. So one by one, you know, we are going to discuss different elements which impact the drama and the success of drama in literature. Number one is the unity of time. Friends, you must have heard the name of Aristotle. Who was Aristotle? Aristotle was a great Greek philosopher who had written the Poetics. In the Poetics, he has discussed what a tragedy is. He has discussed different elements, features of tragedy. And friends, there he rightly said, Aristotle rightly said, that drama must be finished within one single revolution of the sun. That means the time duration which is presented on the stage, that must not exceed 24 hours. That means the whole life of the hero cannot be presented on the stage. That is the limitation of drama. You know, in novel, we know that the novelist describes the whole life of the hero, sometimes one generation, two or three generations of the protagonist are presented by the novelist in his novel. But this limitation, this is the limitation in drama, where the dramatist presents only the life of 24 hours from the life of the protagonist to be presented on the stage. So that is the limitation here. F.R. Lewis, an important critic of English drama, has rightly said that the drama must not be too long like an island and must not be too short like an eye of a fly. Okay, so it should be moderate, not too long. Why? Because if it is too long, then the spectators will get bored. Okay, after all, the viewers, the spectators are going to watch your play on the stage. And if it is too long, then, you know, it creates boredom among the spectators. So not too long and not too short. Okay, number two, unity of place must be concentrated, must be focused by the dramatist. Unity of place means setting. Setting means the places where the actual actions should take place, right? In novel, what happens? The novelist describes different places with the help of words, right? But in drama, there is a limitation. Too many places cannot be presented on the stage. Why? Because the stage is one, and if different places are presented in the play, in the drama, then sometimes it becomes difficult for the director of the drama to show so many places on the stage. So the dramatist has a limitation that he has to confine himself to a limited number of places, okay, to present different actions on the stage. Number three, unity of action, right? Now the novelist presents n number of actions in his novels because he has the liberty and scope to present everything in a detailed manner. He narrates everything, all actions, right? But friends, in drama, all scenes are not allowed, okay? All scenes may not be presented on the stage. You just imagine that highly bloody scenes, somebody murders somebody, okay, kills somebody. Such bloody scenes are not allowed on the stage. Why? Because the spectators are actually going to watch this play, and it might impact, sometimes it might create some bad impact upon the audience, right? So sometimes, you know, such bloody scenes, sometimes sex and violence, such scenes are avoided in drama. Sometimes war, say for example, the dramatist cannot present the scene of war on the stage. Why? Because hundreds of soldiers or warriors, it is very difficult to bring them on the stage. Why? Because the length of the stage is a limit, right? So friends, in drama, such scenes must be narrated with the help of chorus. Okay, so the use of chorus, a device, is used by the dramatist to present such bloody scenes, the scenes of sex and violence and war, right? So that is the limitation. Another limitation is about costumes, lights and properties. Drama depends on what kind of costumes are available, what kind of lights and technology and property is available to him in his times. Okay, you just imagine, friends, in the ancient times when there was no science and no technology, you know, it was very difficult for the director of the play to bring those visual effects. We are now, friends, living in 21st century. So we know that science has created everything. Okay, with the help of lights, the whole atmosphere is created. With the help of sound effects, these things are created. But imagine the ancient times before some 2300 years from now. You know, such science and technology was not available. Even during the 16th century, when William Shakespeare and Christopher Marlowe, they were writing their tragedies, okay, and comedies, you know, there were some limitations of the stage. Say, for example, the women or female actors were not available because there were some limitations of the society. Okay, so female actors were not available, and in the drama, if there are some female characters, their roles were played by young boys having some masks on their face, right? So the roles of women or female characters are played by the males, right, with the help of masks, right? So that was the limitation in the ancient Greek times. Not only this, another very important topic or point here to be noted is that in the ancient times, you know, at a time, thousands of spectators and viewers used to watch the play, right? And as a result, if you read the ancient drama, Greek drama, Roman drama, French drama, even if you come to the 16th century Elizabethan drama, you have long speeches, high sounding and loud speeches given by the dramatist. Why? Because as you can see here in this picture, you know, this is the picture of the ancient stage. You can see it is just like a football ground, right, where thousands of spectators were watching this play, and no microphones were available, no sound systems were available, and that is the reason why the characters were given high sounding speeches, long speeches. Even literally the characters on the stage, they used to literally scream, okay, and cry their dialogues. This is also another picture of the stage of Elizabethan times, right? So this was the situation, and that was the limitation which the dramatist of those times had to keep in their mind. Okay, moreover, you know, another point here to be mentioned is the costumes and masks. Okay, the actors were given the heavy costumes during the Greek times before 2000 years, and even during the Elizabethan times during the 16th century, because they were wearing very heavy costumes, okay, that's why the dramatists were not allowed to give them so many physical movements on the stage. So the actions were formulated in such a manner that not too many ups and downs or not too many physical movements were allowed in those times on the stage. So these were some of the limitations of the stage conditions which the dramatist had to consider while writing the drama. No, so friends, now let's conclude this discussion by saying that though drama enjoys the advantage of liveliness in comparison to the novel, okay, the drama is lively form of literature in comparison to novel. Okay, why? Because you have visual pictures here. You can visualize the whole drama here, whole play on the stage, which doesn't happen in novel. But however, there are some limitations of stage conditions, and the dramatist has to work under these limitations. Okay, the dramatist has to consider the unity of time, unity of place, and unity of action, keeping in mind what kinds of stage conditions are available to him. Okay, the costumes, light effects, sound effects, and properties also play a very important role in the whole success of drama on the stage. So friends, I hope the idea is clear to you. If you have any doubts or questions, please do write to me in the comment section. And friends, one small request: if you really liked this presentation and explanation, please share this video among your friends and classmates. Thank you very much.